17 for me. Now, when this came out, I thought this was going to be a contender for Album of the Year. Mm. But as the months have tumbled on, it's become less prominent in my listening. And when we saw it live, I wanted it to be so much better than it was. Number 17, Oceans of Slumber.
Right.
With Winter. It's definitely one of the most musically impressive records of 2016. The drummer used to be in Insect Warfare and is an absolute demon. Like, it's one of the most brilliant individual performances of the year. Is that drummer is fucking unbelievable. I feel like if you really like progressive metal, if you like long songs that really draw you in and take you on a journey throughout those songs, this is absolutely essential. I've said it a million times. I feel like if you feel like you've been disenfranchised by what Opeth have been doing in recent years, you have to listen to this record. It's so in that guise of being able to do so much within a song, and all with real attention to virtuosity. And at the heart of it, they've got a dynamo of a vocalist in Cammy Gilbert. She can absolutely wail. The cover of Nights in White Satin by the Moody Blues is one of 2016's musical highlights. The guitar solo on it, it's transcendent. It takes you somewhere else. That they are a band that will do black metal, progressive metal, groove metal, straight up Metallica sounding shit. I mean, like, what's the fucking song called? Suffer the Last Bridge.
That song.
It like is just, if I was to, I remember a question that came in on the podcast one week where someone was like, if you could put anyone on at Glastonbury to convince people about metal, like if I wanted to drag people in who were like old school metalers who were like, nothing is good today, Suffer the Last Bridge is a song that I would play them. It's a real familiarity from a side that it's big and epic in the way that Maiden and Metallica are big and epic. But it's one of those albums like fucking Lateralis, or like Celestial Lineage, or fucking Ghost Reveries, where you can properly get lost in it.
Yeah.
Like, start to finish. It's a real journey.
It's a great, great record.
It's fucking
good. I mean, I had a little period where I listened to it every day for a couple of months. And, like, it's actually, it's ended up kind of, as you said it then, I went, oh yeah, shit. So, which goes to show again the quality of 2016, because it is a fucking brilliant record.
I wanted it to be so much better when we saw it.
Yeah, it seems to have not, I wouldn't say it hasn't stuck with me. It's just you need to be in a certain sort of mood to really enjoy these albums. And there are so many of those albums where you need to be in that sort of mood that, it hasn't made mine, but I definitely back up everything you said. It's fucking great.
And record. I really look forward to what they do from now on, because if this is the start of things for this band, then it's a hell of a canvas they've got at this early in their career.
Yeah. Number 17. I thought a few weeks ago, nothing is going to come in late.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing. There can't be, like, now it's too tight. There's too much stuff. I'm having too much trouble with the 20. I've got like 45 albums.
I've had this argument with myself too. It's been a nightmare of a year.
There can't be anything that I haven't heard yet that won't get in. And then I heard Permanent Rainbow by Nervous. And it is, if I'd heard this 3 months ago,
so
I think this might be in the top 10, because you come back to me in 6 months and I fucking guarantee this will be like knocking on the door of the top 5. But at the moment, because I still feel like I've only listened to it enough times to just go, God, this is really good. But the fact that it's got in here at all, like when I knew nothing about it, and when we reviewed it, I had it 2 days beforehand. I listened to it for a couple of days beforehand. I think this record is fucking stunning. It's so brilliant. It's like when I went back and listened to it with all the kind of the emotional resonance and all the kind of the backstory that you told me, it's taken on a whole new meaning, a whole new kind of life of its own, really. And I just think, like, I love it musically because, again, talking about stuff dating, to me, this sounds so evocative of the emo music that I grew up
Your sunny day real estate observation, I think, was pretty astute.
And And I love all that shit. Mm. And I love hearing it. Like, it feels like what with emo becoming the thing that it's become. This is something we're going to have to talk about more. Yeah. But it's like no one really sounds like that anymore. So to hear a band that sound like that and for it to be so honest and so kind of, it's so open, and the best of that music is, and it's the best emo album of the decade.
Fucking hell.
Like, wow. Do you know what I mean?
Well, I could not be more stoked that you love it this much. Mm. I think it's great too. And I think Bones, if I was to do a mixtape of the year, Bones would definitely be on it. It's a special song, that.
Staggerer.
There's definitely more. What's so exciting about this is all these bands that we go, and they're early in their career. These are banger records that are outperforming the likes of, like I say, I've not even had space for Deftones this year. Fucking insane.
But it's, well, it's like, despite that, and I think, you know, like, I would love to see them build on this and actually become like a fucking proper name band that people give a shit about. But I feel like this record is, because of everything surrounding it, this is a one shot, they're never going to top it, but this is a moment. This is like, it really captures a proper thing, and that's quite a rare thing for an album to be able to. There's another one coming up later on that just completely, you go, fuck, that is just such a great snapshot of where that band are at that time, and it's amazing.
It's Nervous with Permanent Rainbows. Don't forget, Nervous has no O, so Nervous. That's Not Metal is powered by Marshall. Join us for new episodes every single Friday featuring the most honest reviews, savage opinions, and everything you need from the world of rock and metal. Go onto iTunes or SoundCloud and search That's Not Metal and subscribe today. Premium podcasts are available at thatsnotmetal.net. Come on over there and get our very best work. thatsnotmetal.net for premium podcasts. That's Not Metal, powered by Marshall, available on iTunes and SoundCloud.